Hello everyone, welcome to MifraTech. Today in this section we will learn about home automation system project. Code explanation I am going to do in this video. So in order to do the programming for this particular project, we have to previously install Arduino IDE in your system. So mainly we are using a NodeMC microcontroller here. So whatever the program result or whatever the result we are getting, that we are going to get, we can monitor in the Blink app. So mainly we are going to provide you a folder that is named after home automation system. So in that folder the Arduino programming file will be present. In order to run that program there are two ways. I am going to show you both the ways. So first you open your file manager. So wherever the folder you have downloaded, so as you can see the folder named is home automation system. So this program in your file manager, in which directory that you have downloaded, you open that one. So whenever you open this folder, inside that, see, as you can see here, there is an Arduino file present, that is home automation system. So this is a type, as you can see, Arduino file. The extension will be .ino. So in order to open this program in your Arduino IDE, just you have to double click on this. So whenever you double click on this, the program will be opened in Arduino IDE. So as you can see here, now the program has opened in Arduino IDE. This is the one way of opening this or running this Arduino program in your Arduino IDE. There is another way that also I will show you now. So in order to open it another way, you close this one. Next go to, that is the home page of your any system or laptop, whatever you are using. So there you type in the search bar Arduino. So as you can see here, for this Arduino has to be previously installed in your system. So whenever you type Arduino here, so the Arduino will come here. So you just double click on this Arduino app. So the home page of this Arduino will open. So here there are a lot of options available for you. As you can see, a file, edit, sketch, tools, help. So in order to open the previously stored program or whatever the program available within you in Arduino IDE, just click on this file here. So whenever you click on this file, there are different options again. This is in order to create a new sketch or opening a already presented Arduino file in your system. So just click on this open. So this will open. So as you can see here you have to again go to that particular directory in your file manager where the Arduino, that is a home automation project file, is present. So as you can see, I have come to this location here, home automation project folder. Just open this folder. So inside, as you can see, a home automation system, that Arduino file is present. So just you have to select this one, click on open. So the file will be, the program will be opened in Arduino IDE. So this is the another way of running this programming file. So now I am going to explain you the exact programming code for this project. So now I have opened the code, as you can see here. So in this home automation system, as I told earlier itself, we are mainly seeing the output in the Blink app. So we have to include all the required libraries required for this home automation project. So mainly ash include Adafruit underscore sensor.h. This is we required because we are using a different temperature sensor and different things. So in order to use that, we have to include this library. If it is not present in your system, is you can download in a web browser, and then later you have to include that library. So for that there is another procedure available. You go through that video in order to include the library. So after that, ash include blink.h. This is required in order to send or in order to use Blink app in this particular project. Next, as defined Blink underscore print serial. Next, we are using SPI.h. This library required for serial peripheral interface devices. Next, as include ESP8266 Wi-Fi.h. So this is required because we are mainly sending whatever the data we received in the, we are getting in the sensor through the Wi-Fi to the Blink app we are sending. For that, this header file is, library file is required. Next, we have to include hash include blink simple ESP8266. This is required in order to interface both, like in order to configure our blink app and ESP8266. So ESP8266 that microcontroller also will be not present initially whenever you install Arduino software. So that also you have to include in your particular Arduino software. For that there is another video available. You go through that and include Arduino, that NodeMCU in your particular Arduino IDE. So these are the required libraries for this particular projects. So next, as you can see here, care auth is available. What is this means? Whenever you open a new project in a Blink app in your Android phone, so whenever you create a new project, an auth code will be sent to your particular email ID that is registered while you are installing that Blink app. So whatever that auth code is sent to that email ID, that auth code you have to paste here in this care auth. So after pasting that, so next we have care SSID. What is this means? Whatever the particular Android phone or mobile, whatever the mobile phone you are using, for that particular mobile phone hotspot and password, you have to write here. So that care SSID, as you can see here, I have written that hotspot name. Next, care pass. This is the password for that particular hotspot name. So this you have to write according to whichever the mobile phone you are using. So this is required in order to configure your ESP8266 microcontroller with the Blink app. So next, we'll define the pin names. So here, whatever the buzzer and the LEDs we used. So initially, I have created an integer variable here, int buzz. So here, I'm assigning pin number D3. So buzzer, whatever I used in this home automation project, that I have connected to digital pin number 3 in the NodeMCU microcontroller. So that I'm assigning to new variable, that is buzz. That is buzzer. Next, LED also I connected to pin number D4 of NodeMCU. That I am assigning to another integer variable, int LED. So next, LDR sensor I am using here. That is connected to pin number D6 of NodeMCU. That I am assigning to new variable here. Again, int LDR pin equal to D6. Next, MK5 gas sensor we used for the smoke detection or gas leakage detection. That I have connected to pin number D5 of NodeMCU. That I am again assigning to new integer variable, int gas pin, as you can see here. Next, I am creating one more integer variable, int state. This variable I will use in the later section of the program. Similarly, I have created one more variable, int state 1. Next, PIR sensor we used for the motion detector, that I have connected to pin number D2 in the NodeMCU. So that I am assigning to one more variable, int PIR pin, as you can see here. Next, temperature sensor, we are using LM35, which is analog sensor. So that temperature sensor I have connected to analog pin A0 of NodeMCU. So as you can see, I have defined one more variable here, constant temp underscore sensor. So that I am whatever the A0 value that is I am getting from that pin, that I am assigning to another variable, temp underscore pin. So next, I am defining some float variables here. So float temperature temp C, this is in order to store temperature value in Celsius. Next, float temp F for a Fahrenheit storage. Next, one more variable, float Vout. So these variables I will use in the later section of the program. So these are the required initialization you have to do in this project. So next, in any Arduino programming, so there will be like two sections is important. One is void setup, one more is void loop. Inside the void setup, we have to set up the, like we have to write the baud rate required and have to define the pin mode. Like whatever the components we connected in this particular project, whether we are using them as an input device or output device, those things we have to define in this void setup. So next, in the void loop, we have to write the exact logic required for this project. So that we have to write in the void loop. So first we'll do the setup here. So in the void setup, I am writing serial.begin 9600. So this is the baud rate we usually use. So that I have defined here. Next, a blink.begin of auth SSID pass. So in order to begin the Blink app, we have to give the those the parameters required in order to configure. So that is the auth code, hotspot name and password I am passing for that blink.begin. So next, we have to define the pin modes. So pin mode of LDR pin comma input. So LDR sensor, so usually sensors will used as the input devices. Whatever the motors or LEDs will use, those will be the output devices. So pin mode of LDR pin, I'm use comma input. So this will define a LDR sensor as a input. Next, I'm defining pin mode of gas pin comma input. So gas sensor also we using as an input device. Next, a pin mode of buzz comma output. So the buzzer mainly as an output device. So I'm defining pin mode of buzz comma output. Similarly, LED also output device. Pin mode of LED come output. Next, temperature sensor, as I told, sensors will be usually input. So I'm defining pin mode of temp underscore sensor comma input. Next, pin mode of PR sensor, that is PR pin comma input. So this is the required setup for this particular project. So after doing the setup, you have to write the exact logic for this program. So that should be written inside this void loop. So void loop of initially as a blink, I have begin in the setup section. Now I have to run the blink. So blink dot run off you have to write. So after that, as the analog temperature sensor, whatever the analog pin it is reading, I have assigned to another variable temp underscore sensor. From that, as I assigned, as I connected this to analog pin, we have to use analog read here. As you can see, analog read of temp underscore sensor. So this will read the temperature value read by the sensor. So that I am again assigning to another variable, storing that value in Vout. As you can see, I have created a floating variable Vout. In that variable, I am storing this temperature value. So whatever the value read by this sensor, which will not be in the degree Celsius, that we have to convert. In order to do the conversion, this is the formula, that is Vout into 500 divided by 250 we have to do in order to convert the LM35 temperature detected value into Celsius value. So whatever the Vout connect like converted value, that I'm again assigning to new temperature variable, that is temp C. This is to store the temperature value in Celsius. So this is the required part in order to read the temperature sensor, like temperature values from that analog sensor. So next we will print this same temperature red values in the serial monitor. For that, serial dot print of in degree Celsius we are printing, again serial print of temp C. So the temperature sensor what we read in Celsius will be available in this temp C variable. So that I am printing in the serial monitor. Next, after that I am giving a delay of 500 millisecond. Next, the same thing, whatever the temperature value read by this sensor, I'm going to print in the serial monitor, as well as the same value we can see in the blink app in Android phone. For that, we have to write blink virtual rate of V0. In like in the blink app, virtual pin V0 we have assigned for this temperature sensor. So I'm writing blink dot virtual rate of V0 temp C. Whatever the temperature value I'm getting, that I'm directly printing in the blink app. So next, we'll see the see about LDR sensor. So as the LDR pin is connected to digital pin, so I have to use digital read in order to say like read the data. So digital read of LDR pin. So whatever the LDR sensor detected data, that I am storing in another integer variable int state. So now I am checking if state is equal to 0. What is this state is equal to 0 means? The LDR sensor has detected the light means, like if state is equal to 0 means LDR sensor has not detected the light. It means that the outside there is no light available. So in that case, what I should write means I should turn on the light, that is LED we are using as a light here. So I am writing blink dot virtual write-off. So whatever that LDR status is there, that also I am changing as high in the virtually in the blink app, that is really used as virtual pin number V5 in the blink app. Next I am writing digital write of LED, as LED is our output device, I can do writing here. So digital write of LED I am making high means I am turning on the LED whenever an LDR pin has doesn't sensed any light means this is dark outside, so I should turn on the LED. So I have turned on. After that, if the state is equal, else part means state is equal to 1 is the meaning of that LDR sensor has sensed the sunlight. So in that case, I should turn off the lights. So for that, I'm again I'm changing the status in the blink app. So blink dot virtual rate of V5 I'm making low. Again, digital rate of LED low. So I'm turning off the LED using digital rate of LED comma low. So this part is required in order to automatically turn on and turn off the LED whenever an LDR sensor sends the light. So next we'll do the analog pins. So next we'll see the gas sensor. So here the gas sensor MQ5 we have used. This is mainly used for the gas leakage detection here. So here as you can see, analog read of gas pin I am doing. So whatever the value read by this gas pin sensor, so that I am storing in another integer variable state 1. So same whatever the status it is showing, that I am again printing in the virtually in blink app. So blink dot virtual rate of V3 comma state 1. So gas pin assigned to virtual pin number V3. So now I am checking different conditions here. So if state 1 is less than 100, so whatever the analog value that is read by the sensor, so it will be in ppm parts per million. So if it less than 100 means value, I am making digital write of buzz low. So this whatever the buzzer we are using, it is a active low. So whenever I make this buzzer as low means the buzzer will be get turned on. So when if the gas value sensed by the sensor, if it is less than 100 means I am turning on the buzzer. I am again doing the virtual write in the blink app, like blink dot virtual write-off, that is assigned to pin number V4. Gas leakage is detected. The state, whatever the value read by the gas sensor, if it is less than 100, means I should turn on the buzzer in order to warn the user that is there is a gas leakage, and I am displaying the same in the blink app. So this part will do that program. So next, if state one value is greater than 500, whatever the analog value read, it is greater than 500, means I am printing as a digital write-off. Buzz high means it will turn off the buzzer. Similarly, I am writing the same thing, blink dot virtual write-off V4, gas leakage is not detected. The same thing I am displaying in the blink app also. So this part will do gas leakage detection. So next we'll see the PR sensor. So digital read of PR pin, so whatever the values detected by the PR sensor, that I am storing in another variable int state 2. So I am checking if state 2 is equal to 0. So whenever the state 2 is 0, means the PR sensor has detected some human detection it has done. So in that case, I am doing writing in the blink app that blink dot virtual write off, that is assigned to virtual pin V2, human detected. So whenever PR sensor detected the human, I am displaying the same thing in the blink app, that is blink dot virtual write off V2, human is detected. If that state 2 value is equal to 0, means there is no human detection. At that case, I am writing in the blink app that blink dot virtual write off V2, human not detected. So this part will do the human detection using mainly that is PR sensor. So this is the whole required program for this home automation system. So like I told, mainly it will do LDR sensing, that will sense the whether light is there or dark, and it will automatically turn off the LED. One more is will do the PR sensor, will do the human detection is there or not, and one more we used gas sensor, that will do any gas leakage is there or not. Similarly, we'll see temperature value we are measuring using LM35 temperature sensor, and similarly whatever the if there any gas leakage detection is there or not, by detecting if there is gas leakage detection, means we can also warn the user through the buzzer by turning on the buzzer. So these are the different things we can see in this home automation project by writing this logic, and we can also see what all the output in the blink app. So now I am going to compile this program. So before compiling, so here mainly we are using NodeMCU microcontroller that we have to change in the board after going to tools, that I will show you now. So now you click on tools. So when you click on tools, there is a different options available, as you can see here. As you come to here, as it is highlighted here, board. So in this board, you have to go to here, you have to select the NodeMCU 1.0 ESP12E model. So this is the NodeMCU we are using. So after selecting this one, so this NodeMCU board will be selected. So as you can see, in order to compile the code, you need not to connect the microcontroller to this particular system or laptop, wherever you are using, whatever you are using. So as you can see, port is not highlighted here. So next, after selecting the board, we will compile the code. So as you can see, in order to compile the code, below this file, there is a compile options available. So just click on that one. So as you can see, compiling the sketch. So now it is compiling. So whenever it is compiling, it will mainly check the syntax of the code. So as you can see, done compiling. So in this code doesn't have any errors. So it is showing done compiling. If any errors available, means below there is a errors, it will show errors, whatever the errors it is coming. So once the done compiling compilation is done, we have to upload the code. In order to upload the code to this particular microcontroller, we have to connect that microcontroller to this system. So as you can see here, now I have not connected the controller. When you come to tools, below there is a port option available. It is highlighted, as you can see. No controller has not connected. No, now the port is not highlighted here. So now I will connect NodeMCU microcontroller port. So as you can see, when I connected here, the port, serial ports, COM3 it is showing. So it need not to be COM3, it can be COM1, COM2, anything. So whatever it show, after connecting NodeMCU or any controller, just NodeMCU microcontroller, just click on this one COM3. So after that, your NodeMCU will be selected. Now, after this compilation button, there is a rightward arrow available, that is in order to upload the code to this microcontroller board. So just click on that upload button. So whenever you click on that upload button, so the particular program what I have written will be uploaded to your NodeMCU microcontroller, and the system will work like how the logic what I have written, like that only the project will work. So in this way, you can make use of this home automation project. So thank you for watching the video.